Oh, that's lightning quick.
And a big shout. Alan Donald can't believe it.
That hit the glove really hard. That is out. Alan Donald is really upset. He is now really upset.
Very raw out in the middle and mighty intense. Dropped it. Mark Boucher has missed the big chance. What a moment in the game. One of the most enthralling passages of cricket you'd ever wish to see.
Donald to Atherton. Now that's really well bowled. That is quick and very, very nasty. That's got to be close. Not out, says Steve Dunn now. Well, I'd like to look at that again.
I'm just wondering if there's a little bit of bat. Yeah. Now, is that an inside edge onto the back pad? If it's not, it's very, very, very close. Let's have another look at this. Well, if that's not outside, inside edge. Oh, I think there is an inside edge there. And that's what saves him. Otherwise, he would have been out. I think that's why there was a wry smile. And a big shout. And they are convinced it's out. Steve Dunn has not moved. Now, Alan Donald can't believe it. Now,
well, if this ball didn't fall on the ground before it got to the wicketkeeper, I don't see why that isn't out. It was well caught, it came off the bat handle, that is out. But I'm sure Mr. Dunn is feeling the pressure of all these criticisms that have been coming at him. That hit the glove really hard. No problems with the catch. That is out. No wonder Donald can't believe it. What next?
Well, Bob Woolmer, his reaction to that decision. Inside edge, 2.4 runs. And Donald is not impressed at all with this.
Atherton and Donald had a few words when they were passing each other, but this man is really under pressure now. I'm not too sure if he knows exactly what to do at the moment, but what he's doing is saying not out for everything.
Alan Donald venting his disgust at what's been going on. And he's banged this in and he's just taken the opportunity to just have a few words with Mike Atherton. And, that's probably a natural reaction, isn't it?
Well, that was a catch again. Now, Donald is really upset. He is now really upset and letting him give him everything.
Lightning quick. Lightning quick.
He's not amused out there. And that is a corker of a bouncer. It really was directed well. And this is Test match cricket at its best.
Up in the air. Now then, Paul Adams. Just out of his reach. Very attacking field in place. Adams now is going to be told to stay halfway back by Donald. And I think Donald thought that he'd got his man there.
Atherton went for it, and it was out of Adams's reach. He had to run. He ran quick. He ran a long way. Just couldn't get there.
Tell you something else, though, Mike. Whether we agree or disagree on the events of the match, what is taking place here between Donald and Atherton is one of the most enthralling passages of cricket you'd ever wish to see. Atherton almost seems to have, kind of masochistic instinct for situations like this, and Donald is so pumped up it hardly bears thinking about. And then what's that hit? It's given not out as well. This is very raw out in the middle and mighty intense. Dropped it. Mark Boucher has missed the big chance. Now, what a moment in the game. A pat on the back. The South Africans are doing as they should. They're with Boucher here. A number have gone to him. This was very quick. What a great bit of bowling.
Well, it's all happening. Beautiful bowling. Outside edge went very quick to Boucher. Not difficult. No doubt about that. He should have held on to that. Donald is not a happy chappy, that is for sure. And it's all action.
Running. Beautifully played in front of square. That'll go all the way for four. Another huge sigh of relief in the England dressing room. Again on leg stump. Atherton says thank you very much. It takes the former England captain to a half century. 51 Atherton. It's taken a long while, as usual. 150 balls in 198 minutes. But what an important innings this is for England. His second 50 in the match. The captain comes out on the balcony to express his gratitude for Atherton's efforts. Fantastic again. England going really well. That's another boundary.
Well, you haven't got enough runs to bowl deliveries like that to a player Mike Atherton's quality.
Well, this could be the win, and it'll mean Michael Atherton is 98 not out as England win the Test match to level the series. A marvellous effort by Michael Atherton, too short of his 100 in the end, but he'll gladly sacrifice that for an England victory. Marvellous performance by Michael Atherton. Just short of 6 hours he's batted for. He's been a thorn in South Africa's side yet again.
Well, just in case you're in any doubt whether Michael Atherton ever faced Alan Donald, we thought we'd remind you there. In truth, it was an absolutely remarkable passage of Test match cricket. Enthralling stuff, and England getting home by 8 wickets, of course, with Michael Atherton brilliantly 98 not out. Sean Pollock was playing in that game. What was it like in that passage of play to watch Alan Donald, one of your all-time greats, go up against Michael Atherton?
I was just trying to do the job here then, try and keep it quiet. I think Nasser was quite stamped down my side, looking just to leave everything. I mean, some of those red-headed, flamed-headed guy going those leg stump half volleys to Atherton. What was he doing? It was rubbish cricket. But it was just such an enthralling period of play. And I mean, I suppose with DRS, if he had sent it upstairs and he'd been on his way, we might not have ever had that. But you could just feel the intensity in the ground. Everyone was behind it. There was close-ups on the screen of Donald's reaction, and it really was just a fantastic exhibition of fast bowling at that time. And the game was on the line. Ath had to try and fight as best he could. And it was just great to be part of, you know. I was hoping to pick up a wicket at the other end and try and sort of go on the coattails of Alan Donald and all the performance he was putting in. But That was one of those great games. I think it would have been nice if we picked up the wickets and really gone down to the wire rather than have Atherton 98 not out, win the game comfortably.
But the raw emotion when Boucher dropped that catch of just written all over Allen's face.
Yeah, you know, these days, I mean, you try and play it down or try and not get too emotional about it. But in the heat of the battle, when that happens to you, you are seriously cross about the situation, and you've really fought hard. You've had a catch that's been taken and it's not been given out. You've had so many opportunities to try and create, and when it finally goes out, you just release, and you can't blame Ellen at all. And that's the raw emotion that we like. I mean, obviously, you have to try and temper things as much as you can, but great contest.
I know you finished on the wrong end of that result, but that's why you want to play Test cricket. You want to be involved in those contests?
You do, because that sort of defines you, and it's day five or day four, it might have been on that occasion, where you have to come out and try and fight for your team and try and do a job, the attrition, the skill, everything that's thrown into it. You remember those moments fondly.
Well, we had a contest then back in 1998 up at Trent Bridge. We've got a contest now, certainly if you're an England supporter or player, because they are 105 after an all-action morning.